And I think he's been picking up Diddy as of late. I know he played Diddy in Smash 4.
There you go.
And he has a very high opinion of Diddy in this game. He thinks Diddy is a top, he said a top five character in a world where Diddy's, where the Diddy player is able to always, is in a perfect world where Diddy's always able to execute. So he has a really high opinion of this character. I don't think he likes this matchup, though.
I don't think anyone likes fighting Snake.
I don't mind it as Bowser, but I definitely think it could be a, it could be problematic for Diddy Kong, because Diddy Kong's another one of those characters that punishes aggression and also is really good at applying pressure. But considering Snake can just pull a grenade and relieve pressure instantly, it's going to be hard for him to apply pressure, and it's going to be hard for him to punish aggression, because when is Snake ever aggressive?
Right. And Diddy has trouble killing, right?
Sure. Yeah. Not as much anymore. Like, after the buffs to his smash attacks, it's definitely less noticeable, but it's still there.
Yeah.
We were playing doubles. He lived up smash at 150.
Yeah, Snake is a big boy.
He's very heavy.
So, fairly muscular.
Yeah, so, I mean, yes, he has trouble killing. I really like now how, oh, well, he did get hit by it, but I liked that Rog was not being too fearful of the C4 and still going out and edgeguarding. Because Snake is another character that, like, obviously respect him because he's very good, and, kills incredibly early, etc., etc. But don't respect him too much to the point where you don't go near any of his projectiles. Like, you just let, if you just let him throw shit at you, he's eventually just gonna do so much chip damage that you'll die. So you have to eventually you have to be aggressive. Probably a misinput there with the up tilt out of the banana. But I feel like Snake's not gonna trouble dealing with banana too much because he has his own things to throw.
Yeah, you can just throw a grenade and it goes away.
Yeah. So laying down the C4 on that PS2 platform. Ooh, all right. So Rog taking a pretty early stock. This, honestly, this isn't a great Snake stage. I'm not sure why he didn't ban, because of the starters, Snake has three pretty good stages. Smashville, Battlefield, and FD are all pretty good for Snake in their own way.
So both these players took their first stock with up tilt. I hope you realize that.
Yeah. Diddy up tilt's good. It's not as good as Snake's, but it's good. Ooh, nice conversion there with the... with the Nair. One thing about Rog is he's definitely a lab rat. His combos are on point most of the time. Like, I don't see him drop combos often at all. Alright, so getting that falling up air. Up air,
My man blew up.
That was just kind of a flurry of explosions that immediately put him at 40.
My man blew up.
He did. Alright, so dropping the C4 and B-reversing the grenade. One thing that's important in the Snake matchup as any character is reading those B reverse grenades. Because if you can read them, like Snake, it's not super hard to catch Snake's landings. You just have to read the B reverse grenades, and that's it. Alright, so. Okay. Derek getting the down tilt, but Rog able to just kind of fast fall away from him and get out of it.
You want to know something?
Yeah.
Snake's down tilt anti-airs.
It does?
The hitbox is massive.
Yeah, I can believe it. Plus, Snake's crawl is one of the best things about him. It just low profiles him, and if you just crawl around and fish for up tilt, it's really hard to get around that, especially as Bowser. But, all right, so, yeah, Rob not too keen on getting up near him, but, yeah, he will go off stage for the edge guard, but...
Good recovery.
Derek's not going to give it to him, yeah. Clapping the grenade. Yeah, he's going to have to find his stock quickly. He is at 230. There we go.
There we go.
Don't know why he didn't just go for up tilt there, but fair enough. Fair enough. It worked.
It looks cooler.
It does look cooler. I agree. So, yeah, we're seeing Banana be shut down a lot here. It's definitely still in play, but it's just, I don't know. I feel like it's not as much in play as Rog might like it to be in this matchup specifically. And honestly, I could see the trainer switch happening from Rog if he doesn't feel comfortable this game, though. It's close enough that he might opt to switch Diddy. Or he might opt to stay Diddy. Trying to combo start with dash attack. That's another thing. Dash attack is a combo starter.
Yeah, they made dash attack a move in this game.
Yeah, which I like. Dash attack. Diddy's dash attack was horrible in Smash 4.
It wasn't horrible. It was just that he had better moves.
Yeah, I guess that's true. On other characters, it might not have been bad. It's just on Diddy, it's like, why would you ever use it?
Right. Oh! He spiked.
Yeah. Reading that cipher, Rog taking that game, kind of pulling it out of his bum there.
Yeah. You were talking about that earlier, how. Derek would just kind of throw out Cypher and get punished for it.
Yeah, he probably was feeling a little insecure because he was off stage out there. And Derek is a player, like, I mean, and I don't blame him for this. I'm very much the same way, where if I'm off stage, I want to get back on stage as quickly as possible. And that can lead to me being reckless and disadvantaged. And this was definitely reckless. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe he thought Cypher would shield him from down air. It's possible. I kind of thought maybe it would. But, yeah, he just downed right through it.
I didn't even think he hit the Cypher. He just hit Snake.
Yeah, straight up. Yeah, he was a little bit to the right of it. So going to Lila. Ooh, why did he let Snake go here? This is. I know Rob does like the stage he was telling me earlier, but this is probably Snake's best stage. I would say, for a few reasons. So C4 will hit on all of the low platforms, all of them, all three. And also, if you're both on the ground, like right now, where is C4? You can't tell.
Because yeah, I can't. It's right there.
Well, because it was on the ground. But like, if it's on one of the three low platforms and the camera's down there like that, it's really hard to see C4.
Oh, now I get you.
Yeah. So it can just all of these things put combined just kind of make it a good Snake stage. Plus, it's dark, and Snake, especially with the skin Derek's using, it's really hard to see Snake in the dark. And the name tag helps, but I don't know. I feel like Snake choreographs so many of his moves, both audibly and visually. So it's like, I always like to bring him to, if I bring him to Battlefield, I always bring him to Pictoshat.
Okay.
That's where I bring him. So sending him up into the air, yeah, Derek B reversing that grenade again to get out of disadvantage. He's been doing that right along, and Rock hasn't been calling it out. It's the down tilt. Ooh, but yeah, the grenade was waiting there. Not going to be able to get that dash attack afterward.
I'm surprised I didn't break shield.
Yeah, that was one of those times where you throw out a try or die option. It has so much shield damage. I'm also a little surprised it didn't break shield. Back air, almost going to take it. Definitely kind of like in Smash 4, one of those moves that doesn't really look strong, but the knockback growth on it's immense. Like, it kills barrier. Okay, so getting the down throw monkey flip. Ooh, big damage coming out from Rob.
Big combos.
Trying to get that down air, but Derek's not going to give it to him. See, we saw a low Cypher there too. Rob didn't call it out that time. Yeah, Rob, I think he's one thing that's winning him so much right now, winning him percent, is his movement is a lot cleaner this game than it was last game. I feel like he's able to, and this is part of the reason he likes Lila, he's able to maneuver around so well on this stage. Right. So maybe this was a good pick. I personally would never take Snake to this stage in a million years, but I mean, it's working for Rog as we speak. So, ooh, yeah, the grenade saving him. That's happened so many times where he just, it's a get out of jail free card. Yeah, there it is again. Low Cypher there, gonna make Derek eat a back air, eat a big monkey foot, and send him to an early grave. Also, I haven't seen Rob go for grabs that often. Because, I mean, Derek's shielding a lot. And Rob, I mean, it's working. Derek isn't really punishing Rob's aggression too much. But,
I think that's why he keeps doing it.
Right. But, like, he's shielding so much that he might get more reward off of a grab. All right. So, at this first, when you have this much of a lead against Snake, it's actually not a bad idea to trade with him.
Because, you know, he's eventually going
to
die.
Yeah. So, Snake is a character that loves to trade. And will trade often, but yeah, wow, that up tilt was stupid. But like when the reason that Snake needs an early lead so badly to do well in a set is because he can trade. When he doesn't have that lead, it becomes much more precarious trying to get out of disadvantage. Because you know, like if I get blown up by a grenade, I'm going to be at kill percent. So you're like, you're always thinking about that. One thing about Rog also is he's doing a great job of keeping track of C4. Like he hasn't gotten C4 recklessly like at all. Which is
like
good.
Maybe once.
Yeah,
set.
Maybe once. But like, usually if he gets C forward, it's getting hit anyway. All right, so F tilting him. All right, not gonna get anything, but he can't be too. That's a sticky. He just got sticky. Okay, but he knew. Oh, Derek should have done up throw sticky. That might have killed him at that percent. Yeah. So I was about to say Rob can't get too reckless here, or else this game will be gone. He has to be cautious because. I'm sure he knows this. Snake kills a lot earlier than Diddy Kong does.
Like that!
And there it is. Rog,
You were saying?
He's nodding. I mean, he's alright with it, but that was robbery that just occurred. That was definitely robbery.
Or could you say roggery?
It was roggery.
Kill me.
It absolutely was.
Please kill me. I beg of you.
I really liked... one thing I liked from Derek was he started... He held advantage a lot better than he did in the other previous games. In game was 1 or 2, Derek was able to hold advantage really well. Or just game 1, I guess.
Well, in game 2, he wasn't holding advantage in the very beginning.
Yeah,
but as the game went on, he was
right.
Like, okay, here's how I do this against Diddy Kong. He's kind of learning as he goes.
Especially that last stock. And who could blame him? Who plays Diddy Kong in this state other than Rock? No one.
Zenodo... Does Zenodo still play Diddy?
He has. I don't see it as nearly as often as his Peach.
Fair.
Yeah, so Monkey Flip doing just kind of serving him well here in this matchup specifically. Because he just kind of gets, kind of invalidates all of the stuff that Derek is leaving for him on the ground by just flipping over it. But Rog, his movement's not looking quite as fluid as it was game one.
He's
or
just
kind of
running into things now.
Yeah,
he's running in the mortar and the grenades.
It's possible that recklessness is still coming around. But yeah, down throw down air, that is a thing if you're not prepared for it. I don't believe it's true with perfect DI, but trying to go for the second one.
Gonna
cost him his stock. Yeah, that was a gutsy play. It definitely would have sealed the deal, I think. But
that's not a stock you want to lose against Snake.
No, yeah. Usually you want to hold stock advantage against Snake, just in general. Because once you don't have the lead anymore, Snake's gonna start trading, and then he never has to approach you, and that's bad.
I appreciate the attempt for that read.
I do. I agree. Yeah, I really like Snake. I really like Diddy Kong too. Sending him off stage, throwing that banana. Ooh, yeah, but covering multiple options. They're covering the drop-off with the banana and then covering Cypher with Bear. Ooh, trying to catch him with the banana. That would have been such a good play. But, all right.
It would have been funny, too.
Yeah, it would have been.
Hey, you gotta eat your potassium.
Down tilt up smash, see, he lives, and he's at 150. He just lived down tilt up smash. All right, so yeah, one thing about this stage is Snake's really good at holding center on the stage, because he can just put the sticky on the Smashville platform and it'll hit most of the cast.
Wonder if he would have up tilted, he would have died there.
Probably.
That's awful.
Yeah. What's up? I'll switch out.
I'm good.
All right, so getting that monkey flip.
And he's just slapping him in the face.
Yeah, he gets sent just away. So Rog looking in a good spot right now, but you know, one up till, one C4, one Nikita, he's dead. Oh, that's another thing. I haven't seen Derek go for Nikita at all this set.
Oh my god. He blew up, he died.
Yeah, grenade into
he's gone.
Grenade into the mortar is gonna do it. Alright, reading that get up attack. A lot of players don't do that against Snake.
He has a shield break, but I mean it's at zero. What's he gonna do?
He's gonna start the infinite. Oh, he tried. Yeah, if he had gotten the infinite, that would have been... Yeah, that's so sad to see. But also the infinite's stupid, so I guess it's not that sad. All right, so getting that down throw.
He going for a chain grab.
All right. And... Okay, yep, he's trying to get F-tilt. I'm pretty sure he's trying to do the F-tilt up-tilt mix-up, but... Because F-tilt won't kill unless it's at ledge in this percent. All right, ooh, parrying the banana. Yeah, Derek is doing such a good job of playing around banana. He hasn't gotten caught with that very often at all. Okay. I thought that might have been the start of the infinite. It seems like Rog really wants the infinite, but Derek, yeah,
he kind of needs it right now.
Yeah.
At this point.
Well, right. You're not gonna make up this deficit against Snake.
Unless you just whip it out right now.
Yep. He's trying to get him on that platform. Okay. Well, you know, he's not out of the ball. He's not out of the ballpark yet. I mean, he's gonna have to. Yeah, he's gonna have to edge guard him.
Derek's
sure.
getting antsy too, so Derek I don't
juggle him. Okay. Oh, yeah. Derek's getting very antsy. This could be big for Rog, but yeah, he can't be rolling like that. He's gonna get up tilted. It's gonna happen. Oh yeah, down throw.
Oh, he had the.
Oh,
read.
I thought that. Was
he had the F tilt.
I thought that was it.
That was like his one good thing he's ever done at disadvantage this entire set was that air dodge.
Yeah. Okay, Derek setting off a lot of explosions. I honestly, yeah, you're gonna want to start putting down the platform, but Derek had that read, but down tilt back air is gonna take it in a
fairly close set.
A teeth chattering game three there. That was so close at the end, and Rob made us eat our own words and made back that deficit. That was really good. After the shield break and he.